properties. The properties first is closer property. So for the closer property, what we'll do? 2 into 3 is 6, minus 2 into minus 3 is also 6, minus 2 into 3 is minus 6. It means whatever the integer we multiply, we get an integer. It means we can say that closer property is followed. So closer property by the integers on the multiplication is followed. So the thing we can say is integer multiplied by integer also an integer. This is the closer thing. What about the commutativity? So minus 2 into 3 is minus 6. 3 into minus 2, it is also minus 6. 5 into minus 10 is equals to 50 of minus, and minus 10 into 5 is equals to minus 50. It means whatever the order of the multiplication, we get the answer. So we can say that commutativity is followed by the multiplication of integers. After this, we can talk about associativity. For this associativity, minus 3 multiplication 5 is multiplied by 2. This is the multiplication we need to do. So if we do this first 2, we multiply the first 2 and then by last, it is 15 of minus multiplied by 2, it means minus 30. If we do this multiplication in the another way, means minus 3 is multiplied by 5 and 2, minus 3 into 10, minus 30. Minus 30 and this also minus 30. So we can say that associativity is also followed by the multiplications. So A into B into C is equals to A into B into C. This is the associativity property. Multiplicative identity. Yes, we have a multiplicative identity for every type of number that is 1, because if 1 is multiplied by any number, you will have the same number again. If you multiply it by minus a, you will have a minus a again. So there is the existence of multiplicative identity for the integers. Then we have distributive property. For the distributive property, it says that A into B plus C is always equals to A into B plus B into C. Or if it is a negative type thing, then A into B minus B into C. This is a distributive property. we will do some questions on the distributive property. What it says, like if we have minus 2 multiplied by 5 plus 3, so we can write it as minus 2 into 5 plus minus 2 into 3. That is minus 10 plus minus 6, it is minus 16. This is the distributive property. It means this thing goes with this first and then this. So the multiplication follows the distributive property also. So let's do some questions on the multiplication of integers. Minus 110 into 8. Minus 110 into 8. Yes, you can do this. Very easily you can do this. But can you make it some more easy? Can you make it more easy? Yes. How you can do it? You can write it as like this. No problem. In this thing you do not have any problem. Can you write this as this? Means minus 110 can be written as minus 100 minus 10. It is also minus 110. Now your multiplication will be easy by the distributive property, because you will multiply by this and then by this. So what it will be? Minus 800 and minus 80. And minus 880. By the way, here you can do this very easily. 8, 0, 8 and 8. It's a very easy thing, but it's just to for an understanding of the distributive property. In this question you have 0, so it is not necessarily to do this, because it is easy question. But if you want to put the distributive property, then you can do this. Otherwise easily you can see that this is minus 880. It's very easy. You have 9 multiplied by minus 3 multiplied by minus 6. So if you have this thing, you have the associativity property, it means no problems of order. 9 into minus 3, that is minus 27, and then multiplied by minus 6. There are two subtractions, two minus signs. It will make the positive sign, then the thing is finished. Then 27 into 6, 162, that's the answer. It's very easy. Next question. Minus 1 into minus 2 into minus 3 into minus 4 into minus 5. Whenever you have this type of questions, there are so many subtractions, it's very easy to see what the sign will come. Count this up, minus sign, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 minus are there, odd number. Odd number minus, if odd numbers of minus will multiply, you will have a minus. If even number of minus will multiply, you will have plus. Why? Look, this group, minus into minus will make plus. Minus into minus will make plus. This will left. So if you have odd number of minus, then answer will be in minus. If you have even number of minus, then answer will be in plus. So let's multiply this now. 1 into 2, 2, 2, 3 are 6, 6, 4 are 24. Now 24, 5s are. But instead of doing this, if you do in this order, then it will be easy. Why? Because it will make 0. 5, 4s are 20, is 0 now. 23s are 60, 62s are 120. 120 of minus. Why minus? Because you can count this minus. There are odd number of minus, so answer will be in minus. This is the question. 15625 into minus 2 and 15625 into minus 8. What you can see here, this is the reverse of distributive property. By the distributive property, by this thing like A into B plus A into C, you can write it as A into B plus C. So this is the thing here. You can see 15625 and 15625. This is the reverse of distributive property. So you can write it as 15625 into minus 2 and minus 8. So now it can be written as 15625 into minus 10, and the answer will be minus 156250. It's a very simple thing. Just use this distributive property. So here in this thing you can see that this is a common thing, so means we can use the distributive property. So to use that, we have this property. With this property, 8 out of the bracket, thus two things, 8 and minus 2 and minus 8 inside the bracket, then this is the answer, because we can make the 0 and then the answer will be here. A same type of question, 1569 into 887 minus 569 into 887. Again, in this question you can see 887 and 887 is common, means you can use the distributive property. So how you can use the distributive property here? As you know, A into B minus A into C is equals to A into B minus C. So by this we can write down like 887 is multiplied by 1569 minus 569. So this thing is 887 into 1000. So it is 887123 answer. This is the use of distributive property for the integers. After the multiplication, we will have division of integers. As we know, the division is the just reciprocal process, a reverse process of the multiplication. It means like 20, okay, I'll leave it, like 5 into 4 is equals to 20. And we know 20 divided by 5 is equals to 4. So it's a just reverse process. Division is a reverse process of multiplication. So we know this type of divisions, like a simple number can be divided by a number. But what happens when we are talking about the integers? What is the difference for the integers? Because in the integers we have the sign problem, the plus and the minus will be there. So how we can do this, let's see. So what are the situations you can have in the division? You can have A upon B, A is divided by B. You can have minus A is divided by B. You can have A is divided by minus B, and you can have minus A is divided by minus B. There are four situations. Okay, four situations. In the first situation, there is nothing about a minus, so the answer will be always positive. Because there is nothing about the minus, so then why we are thinking about the negative? In the second, if a negative number is divided by a positive number, you will have the answer negative. If a positive number is divided by the negative number, you will have negative. If a negative number is divided by a negative number, you will have positive. Okay, just this is the difference for the division of integers, and then other division thing is simple as we always do. So let's see the example. Like we have 36 is divided by minus 9. So if 36 is divided by minus 9, we will write 36 divided by minus 9. 36 divided by minus 9. Now just divide the 36 by 9, you will have answer as 4. As you will have answered the 4, negative divides the positive, the answer will be negative. So this is the answer. Okay, so just remember these things so we can do the division. So let's see one more question. Now the question says that minus 91 is divided by 13. So it means a negative number is divided by a positive number. Now minus 91 is divided by 13, we have 7. 91 is divided by 13, we have 7. Now negative as it is. One more question. Minus 100 is divided by minus 25. So now we have minus 100 is divided by minus 25. So 100 divided by 25 is 4, and minus divided by minus is plus. So answer is 4. So this is the division of integers. So in this division of integers, we can again map. How we can map it? Make a square. Why we are making a square? Because there are 4 things to remember. Now what are these 4 things? Let's see. The first thing is that a positive number divided by a positive number is always a positive number. A positive number is divided by a negative number is always a negative number. A negative number is divided by a positive number is always a negative number. Okay, this is a division of integers. A negative number is divided by a negative number is always a positive number. First two cases, same sign, then positive, the opposite signs, then negative. Okay, so this is the division of integers. So what we have done? A recap of subtraction and addition, and then in the integers we have done this multiplication and the division of integers.